The Mercedes-Benz V-Class original 36 watts charger looks like a general car charger, but actually it isn't. It's a part of the car itself, which connects to the power by its metal plug instead of a cigarette lighter. Charger Lab has gotten it and we will take it apart. The charger consists of three parts, the charger body, the wire, and the connector. The connector is the irregular white plastic to distinguish between positive and negative polarity. Inside the connector are two flat metal plugs. The black PC plastic shell adopts the shape of a screw with screw threads, which is easy to remove and replace. There is also a nut used to fix the charger and a sealing rubber ring. The gear design of the nut is to avoid slipping when assembling. The button is designed with positive and negative symbols for easy distinction between positive and negative red and black wires. The parameter on one side shows it supports 12 to 24 volts DC input and 2 multiply 5 to 12 volts, 2 multiply 3 amps max output with the maximum 36 watts output power. The other side is printed with the name and information of the supplier. The edge of the top is round. The top is equipped with one orange USB-A port and one black USB-C port. It is also printed with QC3 Type-C plus PD, showing that the port supports the corresponding fast charging protocol. The charger body size is about 39.31 by 35.9 by 25.7 mm. The weight of the whole charger is about 32 grams. The Charger Lab PowerZKT002 shows that the USB-A port supports Apple 2.4 amps, Samsung 5 volts 2 amps, DCP, QC2 and 3, AFC, FCP, SCP, and PE2 fast charging protocols at 12 volts DC input. The USB-C port supports QC2 and 3, AFC, PD3, and PPS fast charging protocols. The USB-C port also supports three fixed PDOs of 5 volts 3 amps, 9 volts 2 amps, 12 volts 1.5 amps, and two PPS of 3.3 to 5.9 volts 3 amps, 3.3 to 11 volts 2 amps. At the 24 volts DC input, the USB-A port supports QC2, QC3, AFC, FCP, SCP, and PE2 fast charging protocols. The USB-C port supports QC2 and QC3, AFC, FCP, PD3, and PPS fast charging protocols at 24 volts DC input, and it supports three fixed PDOs of 5 volts 3 amps, 9 volts 2 amps, 12 volts 1.5 amps, and two PPS of 3.3 to 5.9 volts 3 amps, 3.3 to 11 volts 2 amps. Then, let's see what's inside. First, remove the connector shell. The metal plugs are kind of like American standard prongs. Now, let's take apart the charger body and take out the PCBA module. The module consists of two small rectangular and round boards. There is a buck protocol chip for USB-A port output and a small rectangular board. The back of the small round board has the inductor and solid capacitor. The other side of the small rectangular board features two solid capacitors and an inductor. Two USB receptacles are soldered on the front of the small round board, and there is a buck protocol IC in the center for USB-C port output. This is the green SMD fuse. The SS54 Schottky diodes are used for anti-reverse. One TVS diode is used for overvoltage protection. The input filter solid capacitor from Yunxing Electronic is 100 microfarads, 35 volts, and has a protective plastic insulation. The buck protocol IC for USB-A port adopts iSmartWare SW3521, a highly integrated chip that integrates a 3.5 amps high-efficiency synchronous buck converter and supports multiple fast-charging protocols and CCCV modes. The buck inductor is covered by a heat shrink tube for insulation. The solid capacitor for buck output filtering from Yunsheng Electronic is 25 volts, 220 microfarads. The buck protocol IC for USB-C port adopts iSmartWare SW3522, a highly integrated chip that integrates a 3.5 amps high-efficiency synchronous buck converter and supports multiple fast charging protocols and CCCV modes. The buck inductor is also protected by an insulation tube. The Yunsheng solid filter capacitor is 25 volts, 220 microfarads. Well, that's off the teardown of the Mercedes-Benz V-Class original 36 watts charger. After taking the charger apart, Charger Lab found that the charger adopts the iSmartWare SW3521 and SW3522, two buck protocol ICs to control the USB-A and USB-C ports output, respectively. In addition, the high integration also helps the charger to be small in size but good in compatibility. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye!